Hi, this is Luca Ciormelli again from Milano, and I'm here today for another episode of our blog series.
Hey Luca.
First will be Albene, hi.
Ciao.
How's it going? What are you working on?
Alright, I'm modifying the main chain, basically, to make sure that the sidechain transaction that we will receive from our sidechains will be processed with the same efficiency as any other main chain transaction, so basically. It's the usual work of code modification and in unit testing and so on and so forth.
So per my understanding, this is related to our mission critical project.
It is, indeed. Yes.
Very cool, thank you. And here we have Arsala. Hi. Today, what are you working on?
Yes, I'm testing my implementation by means of a Python test. So I'm working in the sidechain transfer protocol and I'm testing my implementation.
Okay, very cool, thank you.
You're welcome.
Paolo, which I imagine is on the Sphere.
Yes, I'm preparing a new build to be tested.
Okay.
It will include some improvements on the batch withdraw feature mainly, and also some other performance improvements.
Yeah, I know there is a new release of Sphere coming soon.
Yes.
Will you pack all these improvements
all
together?
All these improvements, we're planning to release it
the near future.
The near future.
Cool. Very nice. Hopefully our community will test it and give us feedback. And here we have Marco.
Hi, Luca.
Who I guess is working on the new Explorer.
Yeah, right. I'm working on the new Block Explorer. And like you can see here, we have a Horizon transparent transaction inside the database.
Okay.
So we are able now to synchronize the new Explorer with our ZenD.
Okay, cool. Thank you. And if I turn here, I find Albert and Daniele.
Ciao Luca.
Hey,
hi Luca.
Hi, can I ask you also, what are you working on?
Hey, you're becoming a video maker. We saw you just a couple of days taking another video, so it's okay.
Yeah, and hopefully our community enjoys.
Hopefully.
But let's see what you have here.
We are doing actually a little bit of code review here.
Oh, what exactly?
We are reviewing our MNT curves for our proof cycle, and then because we have implemented Poseidon, we are already implementing the other primitives we need, like Schnorr, verifiable random function, Merkle trees. We are doing a global check of what I have done.
Okay.
Yeah, this is quite an important part of it. I mean, especially the introduction of the proper queues is crucial for the extended model. And now we are also proceeding with the primitives and the gadget that will be used in order to create the proper proofs for the extended model.
Okay, thank you for giving us such insights.
Thank you.
See you next time.
And see you. And Maurizio.
Ciao Luca.
Ciao. What is this talk about?
Oh, it talks about a requirement for the elliptic curves that we are looking for. We have a team that is looking for one or more specific elliptic curves that need to have some requirements, and one of them is that they need to support efficient fast Fourier transform, and I'm writing the requirements in more or less mathematical terms so that they can be taken in account.
Sounds like a big challenge. But also
for them, yes. Not so much for me.
Thank you, Maurizio. This was our second episode of this vlog series. We hope you enjoy and see you next time.